kiddo.
Hi, Mom.
How was school today?
All right.
Well, what did you learn about?
The Constitution.
Oh, that sounds fun.
Mom, are you sure we're talking about the same Constitution?
Well, that's a good question. I mean, we do have two of them.
We do? Teacher didn't tell us that.
Well, sure. We have the U.S. Constitution and the West Virginia Constitution.
What's the difference?
Well, for starters, the U.S. Constitution applies all over the United States, and the West Virginia one applies just in West Virginia.
Why do we need two?
Well, you see, the U.S. Constitution gives some powers to the federal government and some to the states. So in order for the states to carry out those powers, they have to have their own constitution.
Oh, I see. But what does that have to do with me?
Good question. But to answer, we're going to need a real constitutional expert.
Like teacher?
No, even better. George Washington himself.
So, I heard you needed some help with the Constitution.
Maybe a little.
Some countries had kings, but the problem was, the kings didn't listen to anyone, and they just did whatever they wanted.
And what does that have to do with the Constitution?
Well, the Constitution says that the country will be governed by three branches. The first branch, the legislative branch, also known as Congress, makes the laws. So, if you have a law that you think should be passed or changed, you can call your congressperson and tell them.
What if they don't listen?
Well, you can vote when you're 18, and if they don't listen to their constituents, the odds are they won't be reelected.
But I thought the president was in charge of our country.
Well, in a way, he is. He is the executive branch. He enforces the laws that the legislative branch makes.
But teacher said the Constitution was the law.
Well, it's the highest law. So if a law is passed and it goes against the Constitution, the judicial branch will say so and it's gotta go.
Wow, President Washington. You and your friends at the Constitutional Convention were smart guys. But what if someone wants to change the Constitution?
Good question! That is called an amendment. To get an amendment passed, you have to have 2/3 of Congress and 3/4 of the states to approve it. Do you know what the first 10 amendments are called?
What?
The Bill of Rights. The Bill of Rights, among other things, gives you the freedom of speech, religion, and assembly. Oh, and the right to bear arms. So, when your mom says you're old enough, you can have a gun.
You hear that, Mom? George Washington says I can have a gun.
Maybe after you pass your constitution test.
Well, now I'm sure I will.